The surgeon's photograph is one of the most famous images purported to show the Loch Ness Monster, Nessie. Many people then associate it with plesiosaurs. The next question we need to ask is Loch Ness the right ecosystem for them? Plesiosaurs are a type of ancient marine reptile belonging to the order Plesiosauria. They lived in the Jurassic period, about 200 to 145 million years ago. Plesiosaurs have distinctive bodies with long, slender necks, small heads, and turtle-like bodies. Plesiosaurs can grow to a length of about 3 to 15 feet or about 1 to 4.5 meters and can weigh up to 700 kilograms. Some species in the order Plesiosauria can grow larger. Although not as large as some of their relatives, such as Elasmosaurus, they have good swimming abilities, with speeds reaching about 40 kilometers per hour. They had two pairs of legs that evolved into paddles, allowing them to move efficiently in the water. Plesiosaurus were carnivorous creatures that lived in the ocean, feeding on fish and other marine animals.
Yeah, that's right.
The first complete skeleton of Plesiosaurus was discovered by early paleontologist and fossil hunter Mary Anning in Cinnamurian Age rocks of the Lower Lias group in December 1823. Additional fossils of Plesiosaurus were found in rocks of the Lias group of Dorset for many years. More than 100 species have been described since then. Fossils have been found in various locations, including England and Germany, providing insight into marine life of the time. The name Plesiosaurus comes from the Greek, where plesios means near and sauros means lizard, referring to its lizard-like physical appearance. Plesiosaurs became extinct about 66 million years ago during a mass extinction event known as the Cretaceous-Paleogene event. The primary cause of this extinction was the impact of a large asteroid that struck Earth, causing drastic climate change and disruption of global ecosystems. The most widely accepted theory is that an asteroid about 10 to 15 kilometers in diameter struck Earth, creating a large crater in the Yucatan Peninsula of Mexico. This impact sent dust and debris into the atmosphere, blocking sunlight and causing a global winter for months or even years. With less sunlight, photosynthesis in plants and plankton stopped. This resulted in a loss of food sources for herbivores and in turn predators such as plesiosaurs. Without enough food, the food chain was disrupted, leading to the extinction of many species. In addition to the asteroid impact, massive volcanic activity such as the Deccan Traps eruption in India also contributed to climate change. These eruptions released harmful gases into the atmosphere, which could have exacerbated the effects of the asteroid impact. To understand whether Loch Ness could have been a suitable ecosystem for plesiosaurs, we need to consider several key factors. Loch Ness was formed during the last glacial period, around 10,000 years ago, by erosion by glaciers. The advancing glaciers created a deep depression, which then filled with water, creating a deep and vast lake. The bottom of Loch Ness is made up of old sedimentary rock, which has allowed the formation of a deep depression. Loch Ness is a very deep lake, reaching depths of over 240 meters. This makes it one of the deepest lakes in the UK. However, despite its large volume of water, a freshwater ecosystem like Loch Ness is not the same as the marine environment in which plesiosaurs lived. The Loch Ness ecosystem has relatively low biodiversity. Its flora and fauna are limited, with a few species of fish such as salmon and European eels, but there is no evidence of any large species or marine predators that could have served as food for plesiosaurs. The water in Loch Ness has low visibility and is rich in organic matter such as peat. This could have affected the animal's ability to hunt and find food. Plesiosaurs were marine reptiles that were entirely aquatic and never lived on land. They thrived in open marine environments and were known as apex predators in their ecosystems. Their natural habitats included shallow to deep waters in the ocean, not freshwater lakes. Plesiosaurs had endothermic metabolisms, allowing them to survive in colder waters than modern reptiles. They could survive in lower water temperatures than most other reptiles. Although the water temperature in Loch Ness can be quite cold, averaging around 4 degrees Celsius in winter, this is far from the ocean conditions they needed to breed and hunt. Overall, Loch Ness was not a suitable ecosystem for plesiosaurs. Despite its impressive depth and volume, its freshwater nature, low biodiversity, and inability to provide adequate food made it an unsuitable habitat for plesiosaurs. Plesiosaurs required a marine environment with a variety of food sources and space to move around, which Loch Ness did not provide.